Welcome to the Old Bob Show. Located in beautiful Westby amidst the scenic ridges and coulees of western Wisconsin. And now here's your program host, Bob Burrell, along with his special guests. Hello and welcome again to the Old Bob Show. And as usual, we're here with Vernon Communications and their studio that actually was constructed and developed just for the Old Bob Show, but hopefully it'll be used for many other activities as well. I'm Bob Burrell, and every week I have special and very interesting guests with me. And this week is kind of a new experience for me because we have four people on board here, including myself. But you'll find this program very interesting because it deals with the Fine Arts Foundation of Westby. And if you get around at all and go to the library, for example, in Westby, occasionally you will see a wonderful performance there like my wife Jeannie and I saw about a year ago. Fine Arts Foundation is to bring beauty and culture and classic music and classic art. And of course, you can't, you know, talk about Westby without talking about Rosmalene and Hardanger. What's Hardanger? Let me introduce all of you to my guests. On my left is Mary Danes, and next to her is Cindy Brown, who is kind of the leader of the Fine Arts Foundation group. And then on our left, we have Linda Dowling. All three of these women have been very active in the fine arts activities and in the libraries and in school. And they comprise some very special women, very special people in keeping things going here in Westby in terms of education and culture and fine arts and so forth. So thank you so much, ladies, for being my guest today. I notice, Mary, you've got this wonderful shirt on. Wow, if that isn't Norwegian, I don't know what.
It's Norwegian.
Cindy Brown here in the middle with the green on, and she was a little worried about that, but it looks very nice on very nice on television. You might introduce a little more Linda Dowling on your left and Mary here on your right as to what they do with the Fine Arts Foundation.
Okay, thanks, Bob, for that introduction. I'm Cindy Brown. I am currently on the board at the Fine Arts Foundation, and I want to correct right away what Bob said. I am not the leader of the Fine Arts Foundation. Linda is our current president and heads up the Fine Arts Foundation. I'm on the board, and I'm leading up a Creative Communities grant that the Fine Arts Foundation won from the Wisconsin Arts Board. This grant was awarded to FAFWA, Fine Arts Foundation of the Westby area, and it is awarded by the Wisconsin Arts Board and with funding from the state of Wisconsin and the National Endowment for the Arts. To give credit where credit is due, this grant was written by Michelle Eng, and she did a bang-up job at that, and she has since left the board, so it morphed over to me, and I took over this this grant, and we are putting on workshops on October 12th in the Norwegian Heritage Arts, and we are doing Hardanger. Mary Danes is the artist doing our Hardanger, and other artists are Mary Lake, who will be presenting Lucet Viking weaving and Norwegian bicolor knitting, and the Coulee Region Rosemalers will be presenting workshops on rosemaling, and Howard Sherpy will be doing a demonstration of traditional wood carving.
And he really, he's one of the maybe singular males of the group here that has such wonderful craftsmanship that he shows. And Howard Sherpy, of course, you know, his family were here for a long time. Mm-hmm. Thank you for that fine introduction. You have how many different fine art activities do you have every year, for example, like what you do at the library here and so forth?
I think that, you mean from the Fine Arts Foundation?
Yes.
I think, Linda, could you answer that one because you know more?
Certainly. We do several things with the school and with the library in the community, and we also do things just put on by the Fine Arts Foundation for the Westby area and also the surrounding communities. The to start out in the year in February, the last Sunday in February, we always do Arts in the Library, which is the Fine Arts Foundation in the library. Work together on that. We have a wine and cheese. We have music. We have various artists with sculptures, watercolors, and other types of artistic offerings that are presented at that. Then moving on to the Sit in the Mai weekend, the Fine Arts Foundation sponsors the Saturday evening concert, and this past year we did Tina and Lena, which is a musical comedy group from the cities, and they did a fine job of entertaining all of us that were there. In the fall, we work with the school with their musical in that we sponsor the programs that are made for the musical. And also this year, the Fine Arts, actually next this coming Friday evening, the Fine Arts Foundation is sponsoring a gathering at the Branches Winery where we will meet and greet Rob Gonzalez, who is a pianist and singer, and from there we will be going into the Pump House to see his performance for the evening. So we do a number of things. We have also had local artists from the area that have put on concerts. We've had string music instruments. We've had the pianist. We had a trombone and piano. A trombone and a piano performance.
Wow. And you, that's a long menu list of all the wonderful things that you folks are doing. Do you have a printout of that you put in the paper, or so we can, you know?
Well, we have a website, and it is www.fafwa.us. Mm-hmm. And that will have our programs would be on the website. On our Facebook page, too, we do more immediate up-to-date offerings on that.
Well, you know, and you can also have it posted in the library and various places around like that. Mm-hmm. That's incredible. And by the way, on the credits after this program, Randy Smalley will put the websites on there and other information you might have.
Oh, thank you.
And Vernon Communications also has, you know, a daily menu, I believe. And if you wish, you can, you know, every week or every 2 weeks, whatever, talk to Randy or to Howard Sherpy, because these activities you're talking about are wonderful, and they're singular in their uniqueness, I think, as far as an area is concerned. But this is a unique area. Now, here we have Mary, and she has with her, for example, an example of Hardanger. How many of you know about Hardanger? There's Hardanger Fjord, but then there's Hardanger. Now, I'll hold this up here, Mary, and then you talk about the uniqueness and the singularity of Hardanger knitting, if you will.
Embroidery.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
That's all right.
I was corrected on that three times, right now.
Hardanger originated in Norway.
You bet.
And now it's popular in the U.S.
I'll hold it here, and you can point out some things.
And it's done on an even weave fabric.
Mm-hmm.
And it's done with cluster box.
Right.
And then you cut out, and then you wrap.
Wow.
And that, I don't think it's hard, but it takes time.
Now, after 30-some years, you know, that's a
it's fun.
I've been told that doing Hardanger is very demanding of the eyes because of the fine work.
Yeah, but it isn't too bad.
How many of these have you done?
You know, I've never kept track. I've sold a lot of pieces, and I've given probably more pieces away that I've done.
Do you instruct other people in the, fine art of Hardanger?
I have. I did 6 weeks of classes in La Crosse. And I've done other places also.
How are the students? Are they what ages are they, and are they responsive?
They are responsive and they range. I've taught my granddaughters how to do it when they were around 10.
Oh, wow, that's wonderful.
And everywhere up to 60.
Right.
So.
And but, you know, if I were to you know, be a student of yours, how long would it take me before I could, you know, do something like this? Probably forever.
I start with a smaller project. Mm-hmm. And so on Saturday, I'll have the instructions and the thread and everything that a person will need to get something done in a couple hours.
Sure. Well, you know, and Hardanger is only one of the many skills that the Fine Arts Foundation, I think, underlines. But I'm sure, Cindy and Linda, that you have other instruction in other areas available, for example, in rose mauling.
Yes, in rose mauling, the Coulee Region rose maulers, here, let me put that up like that, said that they would come. Thank you, Bob.
You can come over here. Oh, there's a real test for Rick Johnson, our cameraman. There you go. can you see that and explain that a little bit more?
Yes. I am not a rose mauler myself. I'm looking forward to participating in the workshop and learning. But the rose mauling will be taught by, I believe, Dorothy Peterson and others from the Coulee Region Rose Maulers. And they will come with their paints and brushes and will have a small project waiting for participants to learn. I was told this is not something that's easy to learn quickly. So in the small space we have, my goal with this is to have people get a flavor of what rose mauling is like and perhaps to pique their interest and make them move on to learning more. One of the wonderful things about these workshops is I'm very much hoping to have some people in our community, maybe even some teens, decide that this is a craft, a heritage craft and art that they would truly like to be able to be good at, to move this art on so that a younger generation of artists will be contributing to our the Sitna Mai celebration in our town to have those young people take on the banner as it
you
is
know,
of rose mauling.
There are several different kinds of rose mauling.
Yes, and I don't know the names of all of them.
Well, that, you know, like you can be forgiven for that because but you know, I have a little story to add to this. Have you ever heard of Paralishna?
No.
Well, I know more about rose mauling than you do.
Oh, well, good for you, Bob.
Yeah, Paralishna is considered the father of rose mauling, at least here in Wisconsin in the Midwest. And Paralishna lived right next door to my uncle, Nels Reppin. And Nels would make the plates and all that for the Paralishna for his work. Rose mauling was very fine. We have a singular rose mauling plate in our home that has got to be 100 and some years old now. But Nels would bring Paralishna down into our home farm kitchen like twice a week because Mother had wonderful coffee and, you know, sugar, homemade sugar cookies. And those two guys, those rascals would sit there with their cup and they'd pour coffee into their saucer of the cup and they would sip it. This is an old Norwegian deal, you know. And they would talk about rose mauling and about many different things from Norway in terms of the arts. So at the next rose mauling demonstration that we have here, I'm going to put a lock and key on it, but I'll come and I can talk about that a little bit for you.
Oh, that would be lovely. I wish you could have brought it today.
Well, I don't know what I was thinking about. I had several things going on. I should have done that, shouldn't I have? Yeah.
And one more thing about the rose mauling. Some youth from the library pails, are going to be rose mauling a couple planter boxes built by Dave Amundsen that are outside the library, and those young people will be learning the skill of rose mauling. Karen Hankey, one of our local rose maulers, has volunteered to draw a design on the planters, and they will be painting those boxes for the library to be on display.
Well, that's beautiful. I know several people who do rose mauling and little and woodwork and all that, and they've been at it for so long. Clarence Olson, do you know Clarence? Mm-hmm. Did you grow up in the area here, Linda?
Yes, I did.
Well, you're almost old enough to be, his age
group. My maiden name was Erlandson, which is a well-known
area.
It's a Scandinavian name, and I have a grandfather who did come here from Norway. So I have a strong Norwegian background, yes. And we always did all the Norwegian things at holiday time and all the customs, the Norwegian customs. Did speak Norwegian as a youngster, and I've lost most of that ability as my older relatives have passed on and as we moved out of the area and then eventually moved back into the area.
Did you have the experience like on a Saturday night walking down the streets of Westby when you were young and, you know, the brogues that were present at that time, the accents, did you have that kind of experience?
Well, we were not walking down the streets of Westby because we lived on a farm, always lived on a farm out in the country. We would attend church on Sunday and you'd hear the Norwegian spoken by most of the people. In fact, our little country church in East Sofia had Norwegian church services once a month.
Right.
Which I couldn't understand all of it, but I thought it was beautiful listening to the language.
There's something about the Norwegian language and the behavior or the attitudes, the coziness of the Norwegians that I think lends itself somewhat to the work that people like you do and people like Howard does and Clarence and in their work with the Norwegian fine arts, if you will, because I think they put their heart into it as well as their hands and their minds.
Yes.
You had something else you were anxious to say.
I wanted to let you know that there are the other artists coming who couldn't be here today.
Yeah.
Mary Lake with the Norwegian bicolor knitting and the lucet weaving, which is going to, is very unique, and I'm really looking forward to the.
That's wonderful. Linda Dowling, you've had a lot of experience in this whole area, but you really you were a nurse, right?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And was that for the area here, or?
The last part of my career, I was an operating room nurse at Gunderson Lutheran for nearly 30 years. Mm-hmm. Absolutely loved my work, loved my job, loved the people.
Right, yeah.
Great, it was a good thing.
Well, you know, you and Mary and, of course, Cindy and your other artists that we're sorry we're not here, they have you have a real heartfelt commitment, I think, not only for your area, but probably to help the art be continued. Mm-hmm. Am I right or wrong in that?
Yes.
And how are we doing in terms of getting younger people to be involved and to be interested in such things? Mary,
I've taught my granddaughters.
Well,
so
I know
that,
it, but, there's,
you know,
but then there's others as well.
I know.
I mean, overall, do you have, what kind of age group are interested in what you're doing?
Probably around the late 20s, 30s.
Well, that's great. Yeah. That's great.
Yeah, they want to make one of those a tablecloth for their table, right? That's a big project, isn't it, Mary?
Yeah.
She raises her eyebrows.
I'm talking with Mary Danes on my left, who is a participant artist, I think you're called.
I guess.
Yeah, okay. For the Fine Arts Foundation of the Westby area. Next to her is Cindy Brown, who is a librarian at Westby.
Yes.
And also a director on the Fine Arts Foundation. And then next to her is Linda Dowling, who is the president of the foundation. And I thank you so much, ladies, for being with us today. How are we doing on the financing of the Fine Arts Foundation?
Well,
that's a question for the president.
Our ultimate goal, of course, is to be able to build a performing arts center in Westby. We would like very much to be able to do that. That's a very long-term goal. We have quite a ways to go on that. We welcome any and all donations and endowments and contributions, certainly. But our short-term goal, which I think is very important right now, is promoting all the arts in the area with young and old alike. As I mentioned previously, we had Tina and Lena here from the cities that sit in the Mai, but we also had the high school polka band, which played the opening act for the program. And I thought that was pretty exciting because, first of all, to hear all these young people wanting to play polka music and actually performing like that, and people were out dancing, young and old having a good time together. And on the other end of the spectrum, a year or so ago, we had a program that was put on by a group of Renaissance music, a group of artists from New York City. They were traveling in the Midwest, and they came here. We had the program out at the Country Coon Prairie Church. And again, that attracted many age groups. So I think the things that we are offering does attract young and old, which is certainly what we all ages.
You bet. It's wonderful. And of course, this whole area, we've noticed, Ginny and I have, we've been here about 5 or 6 years now. We moved here from southern Wisconsin near Madison.
Okay.
You know, which is a shocking move, really, because here we are in a wonderful, quiet, calm, kind of private area. But what stands out for us are the number of different activities that these areas do for the communities. And we were talking about it just coming over here from Viroqua to Westby, Coon Valley, Chaseburg. Mm-hmm. It's remarkable, the wonderful things that they do for each other and for those who need help. And I'm curious, last week I had as a guest here library from Viroqua with Mary Groening. You know her?
Oh, she's on the board, I believe.
Yes, she is. Yes, okay. Exactly. She's a director on the board. And they're building quite a facility over there, I understand.
Yes, they are.
And does the Fine Arts Foundation of Westby, do you coordinate or kind of commune back and forth as to your activities at all?
You mean with the library and the Fine Arts Foundation?
Yes, the library, the Fine Arts Foundation, and the neighboring communities.
Well, I know that the library friends and the Fine Arts Foundation co-sponsor Arts in the Library, which is a program that we give in February of each year. We have an artist come in, and it's for adults because we serve wine.
Ah,
and
well.
Yeah. and that is a nice event for adults and to get together to enjoy music and chat and just hang out at the library.
Yes, there you
after
are.
Hours.
There you are, exactly. How wonderful. And how about you kind of talk back and forth about certain activities you have or professionals, I should say. Like you talked to the Viroqua Library and say, we have these people here. Would you like to post it or whatever?
Oh, ask them if they post on our website. We share, I would say that the libraries around here share our events through posters that we post in each other's hallways. I really don't think we post each other's events on our website. We have links, though.
Right.
To each other on our website, on our link page.
Do you communicate at all with the schools?
Of course.
Well, of course. I know you do. so you send them the literature or promotions of your various activities that you're doing, right?
Yes, yes.
And do you invite any of the teachers to come and be part of this? Or?
Well, specifically, have I invited a teacher to come and be part of this? I think that we publicize this at the school and through children who come to the library know about it.
Sure.
Our library PALS group at the library are mostly school children, some homeschooled children, and they are the ones who will be painting those flower boxes I spoke of earlier. I really want to help this group, become cohesive, and not only do these kids help in the library, but I also want them to perhaps be a group that wants to get involved in Rosemont.
You know, and I think that the Westby Library probably is the operational center for the area, for the Westby area of fine arts. Am I right or wrong on that?
That is not correct. The Westby, the
so
Fine
where do
Arts
I go
Foundation
if I want
of the
to know
Westby
more about
area.
It.
Is its own group. It's a foundation that's been
Exactly. Do you have a building or an office? Or
we do no? not have a building and an office. No. Our meetings are usually held at the Coon Prairie Church here in Westby. They're held
at the what church?
At the Coon Prairie Church.
Oh, yes.
The Vanilla Church.
Yes, there you are. Thank you.
Right. And on our website are the names of the officers.
Okay.
And the board.
Excellent.
Are posted,
and
so you can contact.
And, yeah.
You can contact them, their phone numbers and their webpage or email addresses.
Right, and
are on there.
You know, when we're all done here, you'll be sure and give Randy Smalley the telephone
sure.
numbers and your website identification. If you had your druthers, each of you, what would you like to see in the coming days and weeks and years for the Fine Arts Foundation of the Westby area? Mary?
Oh, one thing that the younger people involved and at school during basketball games, mm-hmm. the girls were knitting.
Wow.
So somebody taught.
That's wonderful. Yeah.
Yeah, the girls how to knit.
Yeah.
And they're sitting knitting. So things like that really, you know,
yeah.
it's great.
Oh, I think that's a wonderful example. How about you, Cindy?
Well, I would, as a board member on the Fine Arts Foundation, I would like to see eventually the Performing Arts Center. But before that, I would like to see, as Mary said, more youth involved in the fine arts, and have the adults around them supporting them and making sure that their efforts are appreciated in the community.
And you work closely with Linda.
Yes, and the Fine Arts Foundation.
Yes, that's right. And Linda, mm-hmm. how about you?
Well, of course, my ultimate dream would be to see the construction of the Performing Arts Center and also then the utilization by Westby and the surrounding area by all age groups of such a center. Not only musical offerings, but also art and the other things that we have. And as Cindy said, I would certainly hope that we could include many of the young people, which we certainly have been trying to do, as I've indicated before. But until we reach our goal, financial goal, of being able to build a Performing Arts Center, I would hope that we would be able to continue to provide some of these very good offerings that we have.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I want to thank all of you ladies for being my guests today, Mary, thank Cindy, you. And Linda. And I'll tell you what, you have got just a wonderful offering and gifts for this whole area community, and we wish you nothing but success and luck. Good luck to all of you. Thanks for being with me today.
Thank you.
That winds it up for the day and on Fine Arts. Next week, finally, we're having Teddy Thompson, Dr. Teddy Thompson here. My guest, he is the paperless doctor that I've been telling you about. You go to his office, you forget about insurance and forget about paperwork and a whole slew of staff members. You walk in and you're treated directly and kindly, and you put cash on the table when you're done. Very, very excellent. It's a very fair charge, and you're taken care of. And there are more and more doctors like that are trending now in the area. So look forward to that. Thank you again, ladies. Thank you so much for being with us, all of you out there in the Westby area and the Stoddard area and the Viroqua area, etc. You have a good week. Thank you.
You've been watching The Old Bob Show on your community channel. Check your guide for other Old Bob programming and have a good day.